In this video, we will take a look at SAP S/4HANA Asset Management for Resource Scheduling. I started out with my personalized Fiori launchpad, which has all the tiles and insights relevant to my job as a maintenance scheduler. Let's start by going into the scheduling overview page. Here I have some quick insights into the upcoming workload. But before I begin, I would like to also point out that the solution offers embedded help. This means that whether I'm new to the software or I just need a quick refresher, the embedded help can help me navigate through my daily tasks. In this view, I also have the ability to filter by the exact data that's relevant for me, including the ability to adapt by preferred filters. Next, I'll quickly take a look at the upcoming workload, utilization metrics, as well as my current schedules. Now, I'm ready to go take a look at the work center capacities. This app is where I can manage my work center utilization. At the top, I can first define the filters that dictate the orders and operations I would like to view. These filters allow me to get very granular in defining exactly what data I'd like to interact with. Below that, I have a quick view of the orders and operations defined in the filter. By selecting an operation or an order, I have some quick links to take action. Similarly, I can define the exact data I'd like to view for both the orders and operations. On the right-hand side, I have an interactive chart showing my work center utilization. After quickly taking a look at my yearly capacities and workload to date, I'll get into some more granular weekly planning. Here, I'm just looking at my three work centers and want to view the capacities against several criteria such as priority, order type, maintenance activity type, processing status, as well as control key. Moving forward, we will dive into creating maintenance schedules. Now, I noticed earlier I had some unassigned work with operations in the last 6 months. I will also filter by very high priorities, reactive maintenance, a processing status of due, as well as orders not already included in a schedule. Now that I've identified the orders and operations to be included in the schedule, I have a couple options. First, I could create an entirely new schedule. Having my capacities visible during this process makes it easier to define the ideal time to create such schedules, or I could add this to an existing schedule, which we will do in this case. I will allow the software to automatically schedule the orders based on the predefined logic. The solution decides the optimal schedule sequence, and from here I can refine as I see fit. Furthermore, the utilization forecast shows me any daily capacities, making it easy to see if I have any potential bottlenecks. On the left, I can see the old list of orders and operations, and I can easily make changes by selecting given dates or selecting the start date from the drop-down menu. I decide that everything on the schedule looks good, but also would like to collaborate with other schedulers and reviewers in the process. Here on the activity log, I've already added some colleagues who can review, but could easily add other collaborators to provide any feedback into the schedule if relevant. The next step is to save and dispatch order operations. But before doing so, I want to take one last look at my daily forecasts. The graphical views can be viewed in a simplified list or enhanced to full screen for simplified viewing. The capacities look optimal, and the schedule is ready to be saved and dispatched. Once I save and dispatch, the processing status thus changes from scheduled in draft to dispatched, and as a result, a must start on constraint is set for the start date of the operation. Lastly, I will freeze the schedule so it is ready for execution. The solution enables collaboration across the entire process. When added as a reviewer planner, these colleagues will be notified. Such colleagues can view, edit, and comment within the activity log. This in turn allows for constant transparency and communication amongst all stakeholders. Users can also leverage an interactive Gantt chart to schedule orders and operations. Much like the other apps viewed, I can define the important criteria to reflect the data I wish to interact with. Furthermore, I can also view orders or a combination of orders and resources, which reflects my work center capacity. If I notice any capacity issues, I can easily adjust the manpower per day to optimize my work center assignments and put our team in the best position to complete the tasks ahead. We are viewing several different elements which are reflected in the corresponding legend. I can also edit the settings of the Gantt to render my preferred layout and views, including the core master data that is represented within the orders and operations. A huge benefit to this solution is the native integration to SAP. On an order, I can easily drill into the data to view any additional information or to make any changes to the order itself. Now I will make direct people assignments to the operation. This is integrated with HR master data and can show all working hours as well as any other conflicts when making scheduling assignments. From the Gantt, I also have the ability to select several objects at once, as well as dispatch the selected orders and operations. From an ease of use standpoint, the solution also allows me to drag and drop orders and operations, making it easier to make schedule changes on the fly. Many organizations also require an asset-centric scheduling view of their assets. Here we can view the top-down level of a functional location hierarchy and all of the corresponding maintenance taking place under the superior asset. This view allows organizations to visually schedule their assets and any corresponding maintenance taking place. I can view key info such as maintenance events, order status, and when exactly assets are under maintenance. Here I have an order scheduled outside of the maintenance event. Ideally, it should take place during such a shutdown, so I'll put it within the defined parameters of the scheduled event. Aside from drag and drop, users can also manually enter a must start time to efficiently make changes. Let's revisit the initial schedule that we created at the beginning of the demo. Here we can visualize key metrics such as work completed versus planned, attainment, as well as the entirety of the work assignments to be completed with its corresponding status. As work progresses, the schedule attainment becomes more complete. However, there's also been some changes in the schedule, such as operations completed in addition, along with other operations dispatched in addition. Such changes are easily visible and specifically identified. We've made it to the end and the schedule is now fully complete. Upon completing the schedule, I can view critical benchmarks. In this scenario, we actually executed a bit more work than what was actually planned, but this was a result of some operations being added in addition during execution, along with a few others taking a bit longer than originally planned. These type of insights help us make more efficient schedules going forward so we can have the most accurate forecast possible to complete work on time.